At the end of this video, you'll understand Bitcoin and how it works because I'll make it easy even for you. Hey, I'm Cătălin and I'm a big fan of Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies. And I really like to help people like you understand and use cryptocurrencies and also make a lot of money as this technology develops. So you're here to learn about Bitcoin, right? Let's just start by saying that you don't have to understand everything about Bitcoin in order to use it. Just like you don't have to understand everything when you use your credit or debit card. You just go to the store, buy something, use your card, and it takes money out of your bank account. It just works. Let's imagine that we're both sitting on a bench in the park. I have one apple and I give it to you. Now I have zero apples and you have one apple. We don't need another person to approve and confirm that that's the case. We both know that I have zero apples and you have one apple. You can do whatever you do with your apple. The same with money. If I have $1 and I give it to you, you are the owner of the dollar and you can do whatever you want with it. Now let's say we cannot meet in the park and I want to send an image of an apple to you over the internet. It's more complicated now that I have a digital product that I want to transmit and I cannot prove that I have only one copy and I am sending its ownership to you. Just because I sent an image to you over the internet, that doesn't give you ownership over it, right? I can make a lot of copies of that image without you knowing, and I could send that image to a lot of other people. So it's even harder with money. How do I prove that I have only $1 to spend and I send it to you and I don't spend it anywhere else? We must track this information somewhere public where we can both see how we are using that dollar. Something like a public journal of transactions where we can both see how much money I send, how much money I receive, how I spend my money, and how we are both doing that. But who do we trust with this public journal of transaction? Do we trust me? Do we trust you? The government, the police? Who can we really trust? And the solution is simple. We trust everyone. Instead of putting all this information, this public journal of transactions on a single computer, we put it on all the computers in the network. This way, there's no single point of failure. No authority, no corruption, no censorship. When I spend $1, everyone on the network will know that I spent that dollar and I won't be able to cheat and spend that money somewhere else. The network knows all the time what you own and what you spend, and you cannot spend more than you have. Bitcoin works just like that. Bitcoins are digital coins that you send over the internet. There's a public ledger called blockchain where all the transactions are recorded. Anyone, anytime can see all that is happening on the network. This creates a safe and secure space for us to trade these coins between us. It removes the need of a middleman or a third party in order to make sure that I have one coin and I transfer its ownership to you. Does all this make sense to you so far? Write yes in the comments below. If not, let me know what questions you might have. You might think that we already have secure ways to make transactions online, like banks, PayPal, or other alternatives. But there are some benefits that Bitcoin has over the others. For example, you can use Bitcoin in every country as long as you have access to the internet. Anyone can join and there are no limits. No sex, ethnicity, citizenship, religion, no restrictions like that. Absolutely anyone can join. You can make a wallet, a Bitcoin wallet for your dog if you want to. Also, your account cannot be frozen. No government, no judge, no police. No one can have access to your funds, just you. When we make transactions with cryptocurrency, we transfer this money from person to person without the need of a bank or a middleman or a third party. That means the fees are much lower. If you want to send money abroad, it will cost you a lot. But with Bitcoin or cryptocurrencies, it will cost you just a few cents. To get started with Bitcoin, you should know there are many currency exchanges where you can buy and sell Bitcoin in exchange for all the major currencies. As I'm recording this, the price of one Bitcoin is $5,600. But that doesn't mean that you have to own this many dollars in order to buy Bitcoin. The smallest unit of Bitcoin is called Satoshi. And one Bitcoin equals 100 million Satoshi. So if you want to, you can buy $100 worth of Bitcoin. At the current price, that will mean you will buy 1,800,000 Satoshi, or 0.018 Bitcoin. Bitcoins are stored in digital wallets on your computer or your mobile device. I will discuss Bitcoin wallets in a future video, so you might want to subscribe to this channel to watch that video straight away. The most secure wallet is a physical one, and I prefer the Ledger. Here is how it looks like. It's the safest and most secure wallet because it connects to the computer and the internet only when you make transactions with cryptocurrencies. Sending Bitcoins, it's easy. All you have to do is scan a QR code or paste in the address you want to send the coins to, enter the amount you want to send, and press submit. You can purchase anything with Bitcoin as long as the seller accepts Bitcoin payments. While you can buy anything with Bitcoin, most people right now use Bitcoin as a long-term investment. Buying and holding Bitcoin for a long period of time, hoping that will go up in value in the future. The math behind Bitcoin and the rules of economics makes it a very attractive asset with very high returns. I told you before about the Bitcoin blockchain, the public journal of transactions where all the transactions are recorded. The whole Bitcoin network is secured by the miners. The miners are people who own very powerful computers that are rewarded newly generated Bitcoins for verifying transactions and securing the network. After the transactions are verified, they are added to the public ledger, the Bitcoin blockchain. I hope you understand better now what Bitcoin is and how it works. In my next video, I'll discuss the top 3 things that you should be careful about when starting with Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies. If you enjoyed this video, click that like button down below and let me know what's your biggest takeaway. And be sure to subscribe for new videos every single week. And if you know someone that will benefit from watching this, please be sure to share this with them. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.